pieces and moments in Miss Miller and Mr. Starkey's class. We hope you enjoy our presentation of our favorite parts of fifth grade. The first quarter, we learned about the Civil War and food webs and food chains in social studies and science. The first field trip we took this year was our Chattanooga trip. We went to many cool places that tie into what we learned in science and social studies.
Wildcat Tower is in the spot that soldiers would look out and see what was coming. It was also a memorial for the battle that was fought there and the lives that were lost. You could climb the tower and see the landscape where the battle was fought. The battle that was fought at that spot was the Chickamauga Battle. It was one of the largest battles in the South. We also went to a museum called the Chickamauga Museum. We got to see cool artifacts that were recovered from the battle. How big the cannons were, different guns from different times, and many other cool things.
We went to the Incline Railroad, and the Incline Railroad is used to transport people up and down Lookout Mountain. There you can see there's a picture of us on it, and the Lookout Mountain was the Southerners' territory in the Civil War, and they used it to see if enemies were coming or if reinforcements were coming. The view there was really good. As you can see there, you can see miles in any direction.
Okay, so we went to the Audubon Society of Chattanooga. At the Audubon Society of Chattanooga, we got to dissect owl pellets and learn what the part of the food chain is. We also got to learn about the different types of birds and their pets, and their eggs. We got to feel the difference of weight between a small egg and a bigger egg by holding them. And we got to see what the owls would eat by seeing leftover bones or pieces of food in the pellets. And it was fun to have a hands-on activity while learning about food chains and food webs.
We got to go to the Chattanooga Zoo and sleep over because we were learning about food webs and food chains. We got to take a tour of the zoo with only our classes. It was cool to go to the zoo with no one else there. We also got to touch and hold different animals. We could see how the animals acted in the day and at night. We visited with Oliver the Sloth. He was so cute.
This animal over here is our fifth grade mascot. It's called the Hyrax, but we like to call it the Gopher Elephant Hillbilly. Believe it or not, this animal is a distant relative of an elephant. See the similarities between it and us fifth graders.
The Civil War simulation is about the Civil War, and you're in a troop of three other people. Each troop is on the Union or Confederate side. In our class, almost all of us died. I was one of those who died. I won't spoil the rest, but we had fun learning about the war, the battles, and the day-to-day life of the soldier. We also enjoyed Civil War Day, where we wrote Civil War slang. We cooked Johnny cakes and more. We wrote with Barry, and we did even more cool stuff.
Corner, we did a really fun pioneer simulation and rotation day. In the simulation, we made decisions that could work towards our advantage or disadvantage. On our rotation day, we had a lot of fun. There wasn't as much stress as in the simulation, but we did many fun and cool activities.
In our simulation, we are expanding westward toward Oregon like the pioneers before us. Even though none of us survived, we still had a lot of fun. We had to use our wits, instincts, and what we had learned about the Oregon Trail to survive. The smallest of decisions or details can mean wind you up in quite a bad predicament. On Pioneer Day, we made butterfur designs into wood and bound books. And we made butter with heavy whipping cream and a lot of creative shaking. We bound books with miscounts, and we used 2 pieces of cardboard, 10 pieces of paper, and 1 piece of rope to bind them all together. And with Mr. Starkey, we burnt designs into wood, as you can see in that picture up there.
One of our favorite field trips was to the Lost Sea. We learned a lot about the environment while having a lot of fun. We walked to the lake, got in boats, and observed the fish. We rode on boats while observing the underground lake and learned a lot from the tour guide. We also got to feed the fish and feel the water and learn the history of the lake. We couldn't touch anything in the cave because it could lessen its chances of surviving, and that was pretty hard. There were crystals and they were thousands of years old, and it was the largest population of them. That was our trip to the Lost Sea.
Hi, I'm Parker and this is Jackson.
Hello.
We're here to talk to you about our World War I simulation.
First, we prepared the battlefield. We flipped tables on their sides to simulate the trenches and gave each team 3 buckets of paper bags.
The teams were divided evenly into 2 groups.
Then the war started.
If you moved barely out of the trench, you could have been hit by a crossfire. It was a lot harder than most of us would have expected.
We really learned how hard it was to move a single inch in trench warfare.
Good morning, my name is Camila, and today we're going to tell you about women's suffrage movement. In our rotations, we learned about women's suffrage movement individually and with our group. We incorporated math, poetry, art, and many other skills while learning. One of our rotations is when we got to do radio commercials. We videoed a skit about women getting the promotion of the right to vote, which was the 19th Amendment. I think it was really cool how we made acting into women's suffrage movement. We also read an article about women's suffragettes. We had questions attached to it afterward. It was fun to search up the answers on the web.
For our third rotation, we did 1920s pictures coordinate graph. This fit perfectly into what we were doing in math, which was coordinate graph. There were all sorts of pictures on the graph that related to the 1920s that we had to find and list the coordinate pair of. For example, there was a picture of Charlie Chaplin, a famous movie star at the time, and there was a picture of a Ford Model T, one of the cars back then. For our fourth rotation, we did poetry about the suffragettes. Here's a stanza from the sample poem, War Girls by Jessie Pope. There's the girl who clips your ticket for the train, and the girl who speeds the lift from floor to floor. There's the girl who does the milk run in the rain, and the girl who calls for orders at your door.
Good morning, my name is Kaya, and I'm going to be talking about our last 2 rotations. In one of our last rotations, we had to come up with 2 questions we were curious to know the answers to. They could be about anything in a woman's suffrage movement. We then got to search the web for information about our questions. This rotation was called History Detectives. Our last rotation, but definitely not the least, was making the posters like the ones we brought to us. In these posters, we had to come up with cool slogans and use lots of colors and pictures. For instance, my poster says, "Stand up and fight for women's rights. Let equality bloom." As you can see, these rotations were a blast. And if you are a fifth grader, you would love them too. In our third quarter, we went to the Museum of Science and Energy.
At the museum, we went to a big room called Facts of Games.
Then we had a fun time in the theater with the Van de Graaff machine. It showed us how electrons are exchanged. That's a picture of it there.
After that, my room moved into our model house rope. It looked like a trailer without wheels.
Then we went into a room with a timeline on the walls, in order from the beginning of World War II to the very end of it, explaining all the different events that happened in between.
Lastly, we went to a room with a bunch of bombs and airplanes that were made by the work of the book, which we hope you have fun listening to our presentation. We hope you visit the museum sometime soon. During the third quarter, we had a guest speaker from the Manhattan Project come to talk with us.
His name was Hugh Barnett, and he played a very active role in the making of the atomic bomb.
At some points of the project, he knew more than the president about the progress of the bomb.
At the time of his visit, he was 101 years old, and he mainly worked at K-25, but then moved to Y-12 afterward.
K-25 and Y-12 are code names for some of the buildings on the project site.
The plane that dropped the bombs on Hiroshima and Nagasaki was named the Enola Gay. After the explosion, it still got away safely.
The atomic bombs were named Little Boy and Fat Man. Little Boy was the first one to be dropped, and its target was Hiroshima. Fat Man was second, and its target was Nagasaki.
Even though he was over 100 years old, he still remembered things very clearly. He remembered exactly where he was when the bombs were dropped on Hiroshima and Nagasaki.
Having a real veteran come was an amazing experience for all of us. At the end, we got to shake his hand and get a group picture. We hope you enjoyed our presentation.
Hi, I'm going to tell you about the puzzle. We have a puzzle every quarter, and it revolves around what we're learning about in social studies. This is the one we are doing.
My name is Adam, and today I'll be talking to you about independent reading. Every day, after brain break, we get to take out a book and read for about 30 minutes. I like this because I can finish a book and unwind after brain break.
Also made models in our math assignments. Ms. Norris class made imaginary blueprints when we were learning about burning. Mr. Sturkey's class made 3D problems when they were learning about multiplication and division.
Thank you for listening.
Thank you.
Testing.
STEM challenges are a way we do hands-on projects in class. We base it on science and social studies, or just for fun. Like we had to make a paper chair with a back, and had to support a stuffed buffalo named Bufalala, or how to make a sugar cube fort based off the bombing of Fort Sumter.
Another example is me and my partner made a bridge that held 19 pounds out of toothpicks, and we used cooperation in every STEM challenge.
We made snowflakes and dropped them from a 10-foot height to see which would land first. The ones that won folded in the air, reducing their air resistance. I thought if it was smaller, we would get the same effect, but the other snowflakes would still land first. In another challenge, we had to get a ping pong ball up a PVC pipe without touching the pipe. We started to fill it up with water, but it spilled. Then we tried making all these crazy mechanisms to stab or lift the ball, but the fishing line that we were using was purposely too short.
Those are just some of the STEM challenges we've done this year.
In fifth grade, we have played numerous math games to learn new math skills. We like to play math games because we learn math in a fun and exciting way, instead of just sitting down and drawing on a whiteboard. One of our favorite games is called Zap.
Zap is a math game where we are dividing into teams and have to draw cards from our deck. Cards are either zaps or problems.
Zap card is a card your team loses all of your points. You get points by getting the problem correct.
We also like playing a game called Fraction Boat. You play in teams of two or three people, and you capture each other's boxes, unless they already have two squares on.
We have played many other games with dice, cards, and hula hoops, which gets us excited for math.
Please stand with us for movement. You'll need a lot of us to sit.